And I just thought I would try to walk you through a basic version baseball game of Strat-o-matic baseball. There are three versions of the game that come included with the kit when you buy it from Strat-o-matic: basic, advanced, and super advanced. And the rules get more complicated as it goes, but since this is a get started kind of thing, we're just going to go with the basic version. Bring you now to Oldring Field, named for Rube Oldring, center fielder for the Philadelphia Athletics of yore. Figured, just kind of stuck as a favorite player. It's got a little dice tower and everything built in it. It's a shoebox to carry the cards in. I mean, do whatever you want to with Strat-o-matic, you know? So this game is going to be between the 1960 New York Yankees and the 1960 Pittsburgh Pirates. Yes, we're going to recreate Game 7 if we can. Without any further ado, the Yankees are going to have Bobby Richardson, Moose Scourin, Mickey Mantle, Roger Maris, Yogi Berra, Clint Boyer, Lopez, Tony Kubek, and Whitey Ford, who is a pitcher with a fielding rating of 2. I put the fielding rating there because you're going to have to go to the fielding rating is at some point when you get those X results on the pitcher's card, and go to this table right here, which I couldn't show you last night because I didn't have it down here. And having that handy is easier than going through the deck and finding the rating. So I just keep it handy, their position and their fielding rating. The Pirates, we've got Don Hoke, Dick Groat, Bob Skinner, Dick Stewart as cleanup, Roberto Clemente, Smokey Burgess catcher, Bill Verdon, that guy, and starting on the mound, Bob Friend. So without any further ado, you get your lineup set up, you get your team separated. Yankees are away, they'll be first, so I've got Bobby Richardson leading off against Bob Friend on the mound for the Pirates. Let's roll the dice and just get going. Now I'll roll all of these together, that way if a split comes up on the card, it's already rolled, so it saves a little time. You can roll it later by yourself, however you choose to do it. That's just how I do it. So we start off with a 2-6. Richardson's card, 2-6, is a split, triple or a single. He rolled a 3, triple, 1-3. So Bobby Richardson starts off with a triple. You don't have to do the scoring like this. I do, and then I think about talking on the camera and I screw it up and have to do it again. But there's a triple right there. So that means Richardson is on. Next up, Bill Scourin. And we roll a 5-6. Remember, 1-3 is always on the batter's card. 4-6 is always on the pitcher's card. So 5-6, that's a strikeout. So Scourin strikes out, and that's going to leave Richardson on second. On third with his triple, brings up Mickey Mantle, the Mighty Mick, one out. We roll a 4-9, pitcher's card, and then his ground ball, second base, C. You'll recall over here, ground ball C, you go to the table, batter at first is out, all runners advance one base. We did not play infield in. That means Mickey Mantle is out. We'll call it 3-1. Richardson scores, marking RBI on Mantle. Yankees are up 1-0. Next is Roger Maris. He's not focusing, but he's there. 3-7 on the batter's card. 3-7, column 3, number 7, home run is a split of 1, fly ball to right is 2-20. That's a 5, so fly ball to right, out number 3. And Yankees start with a run. So we'll change things around here real quick, best we can. Add dunk, friend's card. Okay, I brought Oldring Field. it's just hard to reach all the way over there with my right hand. But I'll show you how my field works. Drop them in here. And we've got a 4-7 for Don Hoke leading off Whitey Ford's card. That's a strikeout. So Hoke strikes out. One away. Dick Groat, shortstop for the Pirates. It's not focusing on the cards. Why, I don't know. 4-4. That's off the pitcher's card. And it's not going to focus now because it's being a butthead. 4-4, fly ball, center field X. So this is New York. Center fielder is Mickey Mantle. He's fielding at a 1. This is how you do it. You've got first, third pitcher, second, short. I can get it to stand up. It's not gonna. Catcher, outfield. You got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, depending on your fielding rating. He is a 1. The split is 16-1-6. So you go down 1 to 1-6. Get the card to help focus. It's not. So I'm just gonna read it. It's out 4, and 4 is all runners hold. There you go. Down on the bottom. 4, all runners hold. So it's an out to center field for Dick Groat. And that stupid thing ain't focusing today. Dick Groat is out. And now we've got Bob Skinner batting third. Yeah, I'm going to skip the field, guys. It's kind of all the way over there, so pardon me a moment. And I'm just going to roll right here. Nice and simple for this video. But, you know, made a field. It's kind of cool. All right, here we go. Bob Skinner. He rolls a 1-3. On his card, 1-3 is a pop out to second, even though you can't read it. So Skinner pops out high to Lopez at second base. So that's going to end the inning. No runs. And Yankees are up 1-0. Okay. Change of innings. Donk, 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 donk. Yogi Berra, it could happen to you.
Yogi Berra.
All right. 6-7. That's off the pitcher's card, off Bob Friend's card. And 6-7 is a single. Can't focus, can't see a thing, but Berra gets on safely with a single. Okay. I'm going to have to get to a point where I can demonstrate stealing. Neither of these teams have any speed whatsoever. They really don't. All right, Cleet Boyer up. Berra on first. Boyer rolls a 2-4. And 2-4, as you can see, Boyer swings and misses, strikeout. So out number 1 for the Yankees. Boyer's out of here. Hector Lopez is next. Facing Bob Friend. Lopez rolls a 6-9. 6 on the batter, the pitcher's card. Number 9, strikeout. So Lopez goes down swinging. That's 2 Ks in a row for Bob Friend. Berra's still on first. Kubek is up to bat. He rolls 1-7 on his card, column 1. Really want this to focus. Number 7 is a pop out to first base. So Kubek ends the inning. So 3 and a little pop, draw the line, no run score, 1-0 after 1.5. Now, cool, next time I get to show you the pitcher's cards. Alright, the hitting cards, rather. And we change sides of the inning. Ford on the mound, Yankees in the field. Pirates come up after 1-2-3. Next is going to be Dick Stewart, first baseman for the Pirates. 3-8. See, very seldom do you use a split. And you'll notice 90% of what I've done so far is done right off the cards, just like I said in the other video. So we got 3-8 off the batter's card. There's a split. Speak of the devil. Triple 1-5, single 6-20. Look at your D20. Or roll it if you haven't already. You've got a 17. 17 falls in the single split. So that's a single right there. Dick Stewart has a single. Now those two stars, that dictates that any base runners on base can advance no further than that many bases. If you were to get, say, he does not have one. But if you were to get a single with no stars, then you can clear the bases as long as you've got the speed to bring them around home. One star, they can advance no further than one base. Double will generally have two only, so that way the man on third's got to stay. Triple, of course, it doesn't matter. You're clearing the bases anyway. So it's... Oh, there's a single right down here. Single with no stars. If he was to roll the 11 and there was a man on first, if it was somebody fast and he was able to get around home, he could go for it. But two stars holds a man up at third. All right, so Stewart's on first. Next is Roberto Clemente. He rolls a 2-5. On his card, 2-5 is a single with no stars. Which means he's first. Stewart goes to second. Stewart's running rating, because he's a fat slab of first baseman, and it's not going to focus. His running rating is 1-9. Now, just for the sake of showing you how the game mechanics works, I'm going to go ahead and try to advance him to third. You take your D20, roll it. If it's 1 through 9, he's safe. If it's 10 through 20, he is out. This also helps the Yankees fans because I'm helping their team actually beat the Pirates in Game 7 of the 1960 World Series. But here he is an out because 1 to 9 is safe, 10 through 20 is out. So Stewart gets thrown out going to third. Thrown out, we'll just call it a 9-2. So one out for the Pirates. And you're welcome, Yankees fans. All right. Burgess is up. Clemente's on first. Smokey Burgess. 4-3. That goes on the pitcher's card. 4-3 is fly ball, left field X. Playing left for the Yankees is. We got 2 second basemen there. Well, we'll just call it a 2 and a split. I'm not sure who it is. Yeah, because Barra's there. Lopez. It's got to be Lopez, I think. Lopez have left field on his. I'm looking. Give me a sec. I'm sorry about that. Lopez has left. Okay. Lopez. And he does play it at a 4. A 4. So left field 4. Outfield 4. The split was 3. Out 4. All runners hold. So Burgess is out to left on a fly ball. Runners hold. 2 outs. Next up, Bill Verdon, center fielder for the Pirates. 2 outs. 4-5 off Whitey Ford's card. 4-5 ground ball, second baseman X. See, this is how it really helps to have good defense. A lot of times your defensive capabilities come into play. So their shortstop, which I now only have one, is Kubek, who fields at a 2. And the split is 18. So we split it around. Shortstop, 2. 18. Can't see it there, but it's out 3. And out 3 is like ground ball A. And you can read it down here if the thing would focus. There, it's finally focusing. Runner on first is going to second. Is out. Completion of a double play. All other runners advance one base. So shortstop 2. And now it's out again. But it's out 3. So that would be the third out. Bill Verdon. Call that 6-3. No runs scored. 1-0 Yankees. Go to the top of the third. I'm going to see if we can speed this along a little until something comes up that we haven't done yet. I really need to work on showing you guys stealing. Yeah, that guy's coming up next. That guy's coming up next. Okay, pitcher's cards. And we alluded to in the other video, there are pitchers hitting cards. Whitey Ford is batting number 2. So we've gotten pitcher's hitting card number 2 out. This generally statistically refers to how well he's going to bat if he comes up. So he is at the plate, Whitey Ford, facing his nemesis, Bob Friend. Top of the third, 6-9 from Friend's card, which would be a strikeout. Probably representative of what would have happened. Okay, for Ford, flip him. Bobby Richardson, 1 out, 3-4 off Richardson's own card. Line out to second for out number 2. Snagged easily by Mazeroski. Yeah, I had to say it. Bill Scourin coming up. 2 outs facing Bob Friend. He rolls a 2-8 from his own card. And it's out of focus, but I can tell it's a strikeout. There it is. 2-8, that's a strikeout. So Friend gets 2 Ks in a third inning. Sit the Yankees down 1-2-3. This isn't the Strat-o-matic score sheet. I kind of found the Strat-o-matic score sheet just didn't have enough places to write enough things. It's not the one that comes with the game. You can use whatever score sheet you want. You can buy a score book. I mean, whatever. However you want to do it. You can do whatever you want to with this thing. But I printed a bunch of copies off of this for a season replay I'm doing, 1960, of course. So, all right. Scouron goes down swinging. We go to the bottom of the third. And hopefully things will pick up because I know I'm at about the 19-minute mark right now. So we don't want this video to take forever. It doesn't take long to play a game once you know what you're doing. Mazeroski, leading off bottom of the third, rolls a 2-6 on his own card. what's the split? Home run or double? Oh, you lucky Yankees fans. He only gets a double. Jeez. Never in my wildest dreams would I have imagined that would happen. All right. Mazeroski's on second. Bob Friend. It's not going to focus, but he is. Bob Friend. Batting number 1. So, hitting card number 1. I love no focus. Alright. So, Bob Friend is swinging. 3-10 on his own card. and get it to focus, but it's ground ball, third base, A. Figured a pencil would help. Ground ball, third base, A. So that means no runners are forced. Mazeroski is not forced, so nobody is running. So that's a 5-3. Mazeroski holds on second. And I've got zero focus at the moment. I'm sorry for that. I'm just using a cell phone, folks. I'm not high tech here. All right. Don Hoke. He rolls a 3-4. There, we finally held it. Ground ball, third base, A. So Mazeroski's going to hold again. 5-3. Mazeroski on second. Two outs. Next up is Dick Grote facing Whitey Ford. Rolls a 1-9 on his own card. Draws a walk. Falls into place behind Mazeroski. So Grote gets a walk. Men at first and second. That will bring up Bob Skinner. Rolls a 1-11. Pirates are rolling off their own card in this inning. 1-11 is line out to second, and that's out number three. That ends the inning. So 4-L for line out. And not pay attention to where I'm drawing. Doesn't matter to most. And we change teams again. And we go to the top of the fourth inning. Mickey Mantle is up to bat, facing Bob Friend. I hope Mantle gets on safely, because I'm going to show you stealing. 3-7. Ground ball, shortstop, A. He's out. I am going to make that a single for purposes of what happened. So Mantle is on safe with a single. He is on first base. Now, stealing ratings are located up here in the corner. Stealing, B. You could have two A's, A, B, C, D, and E. And it shows you what on the D10 is safe, what on the D10 is out for stealing second, third, or second and third, or home, or any combination including home. We go back to Mantle, and his stealing rating is a B. So we're going to roll the D20. It is a 9. B, 1 to 13 is safe. Mickey Mantle just stole a base. Mickey Mantle just stole a base. Now we've stolen a base. We've done pretty much all of it. Okay, what the heck? While we're educating, Roger Maris is going to do a hit and run. Again, this has nothing to do with what you're doing here. Hit and run, it's a combination of two D6s, generally the two reds. So we'll roll the two reds. 5-3 equals 8. Hit and run, ground out to first, runners advance, one base. So we'll call that a 3, and Skinner trots it over himself, and it's a hit and run. Mantle is over to third on a hit and run. Well, while we're at it, why not try a squeeze play with Yogi Berra? Again, ratings do not come into it at all. Yogi Berra, he's going to try to squeeze him in. One out, Mantle's on third. Again, squeeze play. It's on totaling your two reds. That's an 11. And 11 is batter misses pitch, runner on third attempts to steal home. Rolled 20-sided die for result. So you're rolling his stealing. Other runners advance one base. With the batter misses the pitch, Mantle is heading home. So stealing home, be safe, is 1-5. We rolled a 13. B, that's 6-20 for B is out. So, well, that's fair because he didn't get a base hit to begin with. 2. All right. That's fair. He didn't get the base hit to begin with. It was educational. And now Yogi Berra is up with 2 outs. Wanted to show all that to you guys. 4-5 game mechanics. They're awesome. Fly ball to left field. And that is out number 3. So we go to the bottom of the 4th. 1-0 Yankees. Well, I'm glad I just... Yeah, that works. Now we got to see how some of that stuff works. And there's one or two other things. Injuries, sacrifices, infield in. But you get the idea how this stuff works. You do. That's what this video is all about. Dick Stewart at the plate facing Whitey Ford. Here's the pitch. 6-10 off Ford's card. Fly ball center field for out number 1. Yeah, let's get back on track here with a nice simple inning. Bobby Clemente. Gotta love him. Number 21. Here's the pitch. 6-5. Ford's gotta love throwing off his own card for a change. Fly ball to left. 6-5. Fly ball left field. C only comes into play if you've got other base runners. Alrighty. Smokey Burgess, catcher. He rolls 3-7 on his own card. Right in between. Just misses his Herculean swing. Pop out to first base. So that ends the inning for Pittsburgh. 1-0 after 4. 27. We'll go around and do one more thing to show you how to do it. Okay. I'm not going to play a complete game because this video's gotten long enough. Okay, Cleet Boyer, third baseman, facing Bob Friend. Top of the 5th. If that goes quickly enough, maybe I will. 3-9. You have to keep up with me, folks. I'm rolling. Boyer, home run. I might just have to finish this game so all the Yankees fans have something to cheer about. Alrighty. Next up, left fielder, not left fielder, Hector Lopez. Here's the pitch. Rolls a 2-7. And the focus goes wonky, but that's a single, I can tell. Single for Lopez. Kubek is up. And I dropped a die. Crap. And it rolled a long way. Yeah, baseball cards, 1980-1982, Tops and Flair, if anyone's interested. Oh, the Ricky Henderson isn't there, but I think the rookie Cal's in there somewhere. All right, we're back. Where are we? We are no outs, man on first. Being Lopez, Kubek at the plate. Pitch from Friend. Kubek rolls 3-6. That's another reason why I roll in here, because that just doesn't happen. It stays where I want it to stay. And another reason why I came up with the shoebox. Okay, 3-6. Daggone thing will not focus. 3-6, it's a single. Finally. Alright. And no star single. Lopez. Running's only 112. No outs. Lopez is going to try for third. As his running is 112. He's going to try for third. That's better than half. Gets a 13. He's thrown out. So we'll call that 9-5. Thrown out for out number one. Yeah, that was worth chugging for third to see if he can make it. One out, worth no outs. See, strategy comes into it too. You do whatever you want. All right, we're back up with Whitey Ford's hitting card. Pitch from Friend is 5-12 off Friend's card. Fly ball, center field, B. So it's a fly ball to center field. And B, runner on third scores, other runners hold. And as you can see, Kubek's on first, so he's just going to hold it first. So Ford goes down. Two outs, Kubek on first, Bobby Richardson. Here's the pitch from Bob Friend, 4-12. Pop out to shortstop to end the inning. But not before the Yankees play to run. And it's 2-0 going to the bottom of the fifth. That was Richardson. Yeah, flip his card out of the way. Generally, you're done with the game by now. Generally, you're not showing someone how to play the game. But we'll keep playing. As long as it doesn't go to extra innings, we'll keep going. We'll finish it up. Bill Verdon leading off bottom of the fifth against Whitey Ford. Pitch is a 6-9 off Ford's card. Ground ball, second base. Out number one. So we'll score that 4-3. Mazeroski.
I'm for a video on my cell phone.
So this is how to play part two, but I think I'll just wrap it up. You know, you found out how to play. You've seen how to use the fly balls in action, how to use the ground balls in action. You've shown how to steal and hit and run, sacrifice, squeeze play, infield in. You know, it's kind of self-explanatory. Use it a few times, and same with the injuries. Seen filling out your score sheet and setting your lineups. You've seen how it works on the cards. You've seen how to roll the dice. So I think we're just going to, you know, we're going to leave it at that. And we're going to say so long and see you from the Grand Poobah of Delaware Strat-o-matic. Take care, guys. I said stop the daggone video.